ads in all the papers, there are signs on every truck with a picture of the soldier's friend, the good old Roger Duck. And it says beneath the picture, kindly treat with great respect the guy upon whose coat lapel this button you detect.
A sentiment very dear to each one here.
But remember what the first columnist, a Greek named Aesop, who lived 2,000 years ago, wrote.
You can't make a nylon pocketbook out of a pig's ear.
Exclamation point, unquote. That's a fact you ought to note.
Take the case of Johnny Jones,
drafted when the war began.
Now returning to civilian life.
A veteran. He was a jerk before he got into the service. He was a jerk and never on the square. He would shoot with loaded dice, loved to peddle stolen ice, sold children reefers in his spare time. But oh, the charm of army life, the touch of discipline and strife. Through the muck and the mire, through the flak and the fire, the military magic did its work. From a foreign shore, he is back once more. Still a jerk. Oh, the service made a hero out of some guys that were bum guys who we knew. They can take a heel and make him over. Really, though, schlemily through and through. But a miracle's a miracle, and though we sound empirical, believe us, there are limits to even things at Nimitz. Halsey and MacArthur can do. He was a slob before he got into the service. He was a slob, acquaintances would say. His deportment wasn't nice, he indulged in every vice that plagues the Board of Sanitation. But oh, the charm of army life, the charm of army life, the touch of discipline and strife. Through the mash and the mush, through the crash and the crush, the military magic did its job. With the other men, he's come back again. Changed in many respects. Still a slob.